The 10 types of air purifiers explained with pros and cons. Well, they're basically 10 types of technology. Some machines have multiple technologies. But let's first start explaining HEPA. It's probably the one you've heard most about. It stands for high energy particulate, which shows that it actually can gather particles. So it's cloth-like material. It's also the same as like the air filter in your car. And that cloth will capture dust, pollen, etc., up to 99.97% effective. The pros of HEPA are it captures dust and pollen, and so basically cleans the air of these larger molecules, so it's what's best for allergies if you're allergic to pollen. The cons are some of the machines are often overpriced. You've got to pay for replacement filters. Sometimes those filters are overpriced as well. Replacement filters should be, you know, $40 to $50, but I've seen ones that are $80, $100, even $200 or more for the replacement filter. Sometimes the machine doesn't even cost that much. But it's a must for allergies and dust to actually collect that pollen and dust, making HEPA probably the first thing to look for. The second kind of technology is UV or ultraviolet light, as used in hospitals. It comes in a bulb form, but you're starting to see some machines that actually use LCD light to create that frequency that kills bacteria, germs, etc. in the air. So it basically purifies the air. It doesn't clean anything out of the air, but it kills live pathogens. And UV light, the pros are because it kills germs, bacteria, viruses, mold, mildew, it can help your immune system. It sanitizes the air. In order to support your immune system. The cons are it purifies but doesn't clean. You often have to change the bulb each year, and replacement bulbs could be 10, 20, even more. The next is TiO2 nanotechnology, which is kind of a sister of UV light. Basically, when the light bounces off of TiO2, it magnifies the effect of the UV frequency, killing your viruses, bacteria. And so in an air purifier, when the air is moving through really rapidly, you need to cover and treat the air more if it's moving fast, otherwise it won't get enough exposure to the UV bulb. So TiO2 is just a way to enhance UV, basically. So the pros are it enhances UV many, many times. It's relatively inexpensive, and it, again, supports your immune system. The cons are, again, it purifies, does not clean the air, and it requires UV light. Number four is electrostatic. You've probably seen these advertised as you never have to buy another filter. And basically, electrostatic is the use of positive and negative charges across metal plates that can attract particles that are the opposite, you know, that are negatively charged, especially, or positively charged, as in with like pollution and some other factors in the air, smoke sometimes too. It's good at collecting soot and car pollution, so basically attracts. The pros are that it's relatively inexpensive to maintain, to build. They're very profitable. It's washable, the filters. It'll clear smoke and some odor and pollution, as I mentioned. The cons are it doesn't really clean the air in regards to collecting dust or pollen. And some of the machines are reported that sometimes those plates, because they have that charge across them, sometimes can make a zapping noise, which is kind of annoying. Number five is carbon and zeolite. And I put these two together because they're both minerals in the mineral category, and both are very porous, and they have millions of little pockets. And because of that, they can hold gases, fumes, and odors. The pros of carbon and zeolite, they're one of the best for capturing fumes and odors. It's relatively inexpensive substance. The cons are that it has to be replaced, either that or if you can leave it out in the sun, that'll sometimes release all the gases and fumes that it's actually held onto. So meaning once those little pockets get filled with a gas, then they don't really gather anything else or clean the air anywhere else like that. And carbon replacement filters can also often be overpriced. Number six is a pre-filter. just like a screen door is seen in the picture, a pre-filter really sits in front of, often in front of other filters, but it can collect really large particles like hair and some dust, etc. And they're usually washable. So the pros are that they're inexpensive, it's often plastic, which is fine, it's washable, it'll capture hair, and it'll extend the life of the HEPA filter, so the HEPA filter doesn't have to catch those things, and because it's washable, it allows you to extend the life of the HEPA filter before replacing it. The cons are it really doesn't clean that much, just some of the larger things in the air, but it's good to have because it'll save you money over the long run and it's relatively inexpensive. Number seven is ozone. You probably heard a lot about ozone. It's simply, as in the diagram here, oxygen, which is O2, with by a charge, electrical charge, it becomes O3. And that's exactly what happens when I have a lightning storm, is lightning will create ozone in the air, which actually also cleans the atmosphere too. And so that ozone, through an ozone generator, ozone purifier, will go out into the room and it basically purifies. The pros are, it's relatively inexpensive, or it should be. Some machines are very expensive, but it doesn't really cost that much to make. It is very effective at killing mold. It's probably the best at mold and mildew. It can also kill odors really well and smoke. So basically treats the air. The cons are it really doesn't capture any dust or pollen. It, too much ozone can harm the lungs, and very sensitive people or people with very sensitive lungs, even a little bit of ozone can irritate and bother them because they're sensitive. And so basically doesn't clean the air. So I wouldn't suggest that as a primary filter. I use one on occasion, but I don't go in the room when I use it. I'll let it run for a couple hours and kind of treat a room in that way. But I don't use it as my day-to-day method of cleaning the air. Number eight is negative ion. And the pros of negative ion are it's very inexpensive. It can kill a lot of odor and mold out in the room. So the machine will release negative ions out into the room. And it can improve sleep. It can improve mental function and it can improve energy. And if you're indoors in the winter or you're indoors in the summer where you have AC or heating, that actually zaps a lot of the negative ions out in the air. Nature creates a lot of negative ions. Trees, running water especially, creates a lot of negative ions. So it's actually what we really need for good healthy air for our bodies. So a negative ion generator in an air purifier is a really great idea because of the benefits to the body, and it has the side effect of helping odor and reducing mold, etc. But the cons are it doesn't gather any dust or pollen like HEPA does. Number nine is one you don't see much of anymore, but it's basically a little heated gas chamber. And the pros are it's inexpensive, it can kill bacteria and germs. So basically it's like this little heated chamber that air is drawn up inside it, and that'll kill bacteria, the heat itself. The cons are it's very small, it uses a lot of electricity, etc. So you don't really see those too often anymore. And number 10 is once in a while you see little water-based air purifiers. The pros are it's inexpensive because you're not replacing the filter, you're just changing the water every couple of days. And it can capture some dust and dirt. The cons are it doesn't remove odor, doesn't purify. It's only good for some dirt and dust in the air. And again, you got to change it a lot. They're usually small because the motor has to pull air through the water. So it usually uses more electricity than a lot of the other models. So you usually only find really small water cleaner type air purifiers. So what's the best approach to getting air really clean? Well, the best approach is really use many of these technologies to get rid of as many allergens and toxins as you can with as many of these technologies as you can at an affordable cost. And that's why the Alive Air 9-stage air purifier was created, because it already includes high quality HEPA, a washable pre-filter, washable electrostatic, a carbon filter, negative ion, and also includes UV and TiO2 to kill viruses, germs, and bacteria. to get all the bad stuff out at a really affordable price. The Alive Air Purifier is now on sale for only $297. It includes replacement filters as low as $33, which is HEPA and carbon together, a 3-year warranty, a money back guarantee, it'll cover up to 850 square feet, and it has auto sensors to monitor the air quality. You can compare it to any purifier you can find, and it matches up really well. So let your family breathe really healthy air. Get an Alive air purifier today. You can follow the link below and get free shipping, or you can also watch the next video, which shows you the 9 technologies inside the Alive air purifier. Thanks for watching.